sticking to Liz McColgan. She won't let her have the advantage. Hustling each other around the bend.
That's certainly, certainly true. And also, when Liz tried to make her point on the hill, Yvonne made her point by going up right alongside her.
But Yvonne did say, you know, that every time we run against each other, it is a battle. But it's a battle that's healthy for the sport of female distance running in this country. It's also healthy for Scotland to have two world-class runners. In fact, they've never had two world champions before. And here they are head-to-head up here in the Grampian region, where they've run many times in their youth, but they've never run so competitively before. In fact, on the roads, I don't think they've ever run against each other before.
Well, the first 1,000 metres, 3:03. The second 1,000 metres, 6:09. So they slowed a little bit, but not a great deal. 3:03, 3 minutes, 6 seconds for the second 1,000 metres. It's a lovely setting for this race. And really, the wind probably not getting through too much at ground level. You can see the trees waving in the background. A splendid day.
And there's Katrina McKiernan, who's a fine runner, the farmer's daughter from County Cavan in Ireland. And I mean, she's the finest female distance runner Ireland have ever had. And she's going to run well at 10,000 metres, I sense, this year. I think it's wise of her to move up to the 10,000 metres. But just look how far behind she is. Look how fast these two are going. And Liz McColgan, looking strong, realises that lap three of a five-lap race is really her territory. This is where she has to stretch, and she is stretching. But every time Liz moves, Yvonne Murray responds. There, she's just run into her there. She's staying a little bit too close, and I think she's beginning to irritate Liz McColgan.
Certainly wasn't very happy then, and not surprisingly. Liz was saying last night that she loves running road races, probably more than track and cross country, because of the closeness of the crowd, the spectators. She says, well, people talk about getting a lift from spectators. In road races, you get the greatest boost of all. There's Alison Boyce, way back. Toonstra coming through, number 13. And that's Kate McCandister also going through. Vicky McPherson wearing number 14. And Alison Wyeth appears to be suffering a little bit. She went off quickly.
And there they are up the hill again, and there Liz McColgan attacking again, and exactly the same as happened last time. Yvonne Murray holding onto her, getting right in close to her, and getting as close as she possibly can to Liz, so that she keeps the pressure on Liz McColgan. And this is wise tactics by Yvonne Murray.
A little problem developing, because we've got a dog on the road and it can't escape because of the barriers. And it's going back towards the athletes. Ah, they've managed to get it out of the way just in time. Yvonne Murray, her tactics absolutely clear. Stay there, worry the leader.
And that third kilometre, they finished 3,000 metres in 9:14. That means 3:05 for the third kilometre, which was faster than the second one. So, but the pace is constant, and it's good pace. And if you look at this class athlete, Katrina McKiernan, she's way down on the two leaders, and it tells you what a performance the two of them are putting on up front.
Pretty even pace running by the two leaders. And working to get through, but just looking back on the 3,000 metres run so far, the first 1,000, 3:03, the second, 3:06, and the third, 3:05. So good pace judgment by Liz McColgan. But the message is clear for Murray: sit there, wait as long as you can, and attack in the finishing straight, probably.
And there's Katrina McKiernan, who's running a fine race for her first time on the roads. She's going to run a 10,000 metres in Hengelo in a few weeks' time, where she hopes to qualify for the Irish team for the World Championships. But this is the territory for McColgan. This is where McColgan has to attack. They're in the fourth kilometre, and I sense that if Yvonne Murray's there with a couple of hundred metres to go, the race will be hers. So Liz knows that, and she's stretching now. She's pushing it, And it looks to me as though the altitude training and the after effects of the London Marathon have both been to the advantage of Lizzie Colton. She looks strong. She looks as though she's running well. Whatever the outcome here, this is only half her race distance, let's not forget. And eventually she'll probably run the marathon. And Yvonne Murray told us earlier that she's going to run the 3,000 metres this year and eventually move up to the 10,000 metres. And she looks as though she's coasting there in second place.
Again, and some way back, in fourth place is Omoro, the Kenyan. McColgan desperately trying to break Yvonne Murray, but every time the pedal goes down, Yvonne Murray responds by moving up alongside and saying, I'm not dropping back. This sharp hill again, and look at McColgan digging in. Every time they reach that hill, Yvonne Murray sends the message.
Every time McColgan pushes up that hill, Yvonne Murray responds. And I think the clock is going to tick in the direction of Yvonne Murray, because Liz, that was her chance to break on that hill. But Yvonne Murray looks strong, and now Liz has got to really drive out all the way. The advantage with Yvonne Murray because of her fast finish, and the advantage on this next 1,000 metres, possibly with McColgan because of her extra strength, but Liz really has to work hard now to try and get away from Yvonne Murray. And always the dread of the front runner is to have the faster finisher. And there goes Yvonne Murray. She's not even going to wait for the finish. She's attacked very early, and now she's saying, "This, if you think you're the only one who can lead, you're not. I can do a bit of leading as well."
Just having a look at the time there, that was a faster lap again, 3 minutes and 4 seconds. So the pace is very, very respectable indeed. Now, I was talking to Yvonne Murray in that interview you saw earlier, but she refused, actually, to talk about tactics. She said, I may have a surprise for you.
Well, she's certainly got a surprise for us, and I think she had a surprise for Liz McColgan. Look at her stretching out now. This is going to be a fast last kilometre, and she really is attacking. And she says she's talking about 10,000 metres in Atlanta. Well, I don't think she's got anything to fear at the 10,000 metres, because she looks as though she's getting stronger as the race goes on. Yvonne running well. Liz McColgan being surprised there, now gathering herself and starting to run well again herself. But Yvonne Murray's run a great race tactically by surprising everyone, but Liz McColgan's running a good race too. It just shows you what caliber this athlete has when she moves up a distance, which people think, you know, she's good at 1500 meters. She's going to run 1500 meters in the Europa Cup for Britain. And she's now demonstrating her versatility, and she really does look good at this pace.
Well, she's put the effort in now. She's got to stay there or pay the price. But certainly it was a very, very bold break indeed, and it was a very decisive one. Disheartening McColgan, or trying to. McColgan's a real fighter. Any sign of weakness up front, and she'll try to exploit it.
Well, we saw her running 26 miles on the roads of London, and now it's 5,000 metres on the roads of Aberdeen. And she's got the versatility. And now Yvonne Murray, who's got a good time at 1,500 metres, an outstanding time at 3,000 metres, and now a future assured at 5 and 10,000 metres. And I mean, she's looking, this is the last hill for Yvonne Murray, and she looks equally strong going up this hill as she did on the earlier laps.
Well, she ran a tremendous winning race in the United States a week before the World Indoor Championships when she ran the 5,000 metres on the road in 15:22. It's not going to be quite as fast as that today, but that is a notoriously fast course in America. Liz McColgan now finding it very hard indeed. Told me that she got the London Marathon out of her legs fairly quickly. She had a slight niggle the first week after the London Marathon, but she's clear now. But so well clear now is Yvonne Murray. So Liz McColgan clear of injuries, but Yvonne Murray in devastating form. And in fact, this is going to be very fast indeed. She's speeded up so much, she's going to go across the tape in 15:19 approximately. Liz McColgan in second place, riding home very strongly. And then there's an enormous gap. What a good race that was. Caterina McKiernan, the Irish World Cross Country Championship silver medalist in third place. Her first ever road race, and she'll be pleased. Then comes 18 years old Janet Amoro, almost unknown outside her own country, with an impressive race in fourth place. Behind her, we've got Kate McCandless of Parkside, and Vicky McPherson of Glasgow University finishes next. Behind her, Alison Wyeth, and Toonstra of Holland, the Dutch record holder. Checking the result then. The winner, Yvonne Murray of Motherwell. In second place, Liz McColgan, Dundee, Hawk Hill. And in third place, Caterina McKiernan of Ireland. The unofficial winning time, 15 minutes, 19 seconds, fast.